Human-AI interaction is an emerging interdisciplinary research and application area focusing on the interaction between humans and AI systems. MOAT focuses on input-output relationships between the user and the computer, specifically on data entry and the format of the interface.
Human-AI interaction is considered a multidisciplinary area due to a variety of knowledge and methods needed to address its different topics of research and application. These come from disciplines such as HCI, AI, human factors, design and engineering, psychology, computer science, and so on. AI has evolved in three waves. The first wave was from the 1950s to the 1970s, and it focused on technological exploration. The second wave was from the 1980s to the 1990s, and it focused on the enhancement of technology. Finally, the current wave, the third wave, focused not only on the continuous technological enhancements, but also on ethical design, interaction technology, and AI applications. The third wave approach has three primary elements: human, technology, and ethics, which means it places humans at the center as decision makers to ensure reliable, safe, and trustworthy AI.
Along with the rapid growth of AI, the way we interact with AI systems is changing too. From writing codes on sheets, to typing commands on the screen, and to GUI that associates with the mouse, as well as voice assistants, HCI experts endeavor to seek effective and intuitive interaction between human and AI. So what's going to be the next mode? In this video, we are going to talk a bit about the new modes in these three areas: speech, gesture, and XR.
Speech is a new mode that most people are already familiar with through applications like Siri or Alexa. You can differentiate between user-dependent speech recognition that only takes commands from a specific voice and independent recognition that allows everyone to use it. Speech is a very natural mode that humans are well adapted to. It also provides the opportunity to still use your hands for something else. On the downside, it can't be used in loud environments and therefore only by a single person in a room simultaneously. Another new mode is using gestures to communicate with AI. Vision sensors analyze the positions of the hands and interpret them as commands. This mode also allows the user to use his mouse simultaneously to do something else. In contrast to speech, it's silent, but it also depends on a good lighting and is a skill most people would have to learn first. This can be especially challenging as most sign languages across the world use different grammars and gestures. There also have been approaches in combining the modes of speech and gestures to provide an experience that counters all the disadvantages. Therefore, you can use it in bad lighting conditions as well as in loud environments.
Recently, there has also been a new prospect of new modes in human-AI interaction, which is extended AI in the realm of XR. Extended reality, or XR, is all real and virtual combined environments and human-machine interactions generated by computer technology and wearables. All XR tech takes the human to PC screen interface and modifies it, either by immersing you in a virtual environment or VR, adds to or augments the user's surroundings or augmented reality, or merging both real and virtual worlds, where physical and digital objects coexist and interact in real time, or mixed reality. There are two perspectives of XR-AI combination: AI serves XR or XR serves AI. AI-XR technology is defined as VR technology that extends the physical, intellectual, and social capabilities of human beings through the analysis and modeling of behavior patterns of digital AI in a space where reality and virtual are combined. This idea of extending human capabilities leads to what we call augmented humans. The rising technology cluster accounts for control and systematic manipulations of complex interactions. It provides much potential to increase the investigability of human-AI interactions and interfaces. The embodied aspect of the interface is mapped to the virtual world in contrast to the real physical environment. This may cause common effects on user. Those are the uncanny valley effect, or eerie feeling of unfamiliarity when interacting with human-like robots, or the Proteus effect, which is a change of behavior caused by a modified and perceived self-representation, like an appearance of a self-avatar. As a new testbed for human AI interactions and interfaces, XR provides four potentials. In the design space, XR provides a powerful space to embody artificial interaction partners with various shapes and looks, from simple non-animated devices to anthropomorphic counterparts, without being restricted to physical boundaries and engineering challenges. In accessibility, XR can capture direct insights of diverse user groups, since AI systems can be easily adapted to the degree or other human-centered features. Next is versatility. XR environment can simulate different domains, difficulties, or tasks, and this human-AI interaction within it can be embodied into these different domains. And finally, tangible training. XR provides a safe testbed for even severe usage or misusage consequences. The human-AI interaction within XR can be applied to many different fields, such as cancer detection, advanced visualization, driver training, medical training, smart home, virtual patient, gaming, and many more. But now we want to give an example of how all of these new modes can be integrated into the human-AI interactions for gaming.
In recent years, we have seen how AI technologies have changed the way games have been made and played. We are now seeing that with the help of VR headsets, players are now transported into the gaming environment. AI is used to simulate real-life gameplay behaviors. For example, players can now feel the vibration on their body when they collide with a game object or feel the heat of the sunshine in a game scene. Gamers can now also role-play. This means that they are no longer restricted to the traditional gaming controllers, but can also use other controllers like a steering wheel or a sword to control the game objects. This creates a more realistic gaming experience. Image recognition is another way the gaming industry has been affected by AI. With the help of deep learning algorithms like the GANs, that is, the generative adversarial networks, the facial expressions of these players can also be captured, which can be used to customize and improve game playability and user experience. Apart from the users being transported into a virtual gaming world, AR technologies like the metaverse are designed to bring the gaming environment into our everyday lives through holograms. This brings a new mode of interaction with the gaming objects, as gamers can now interact with holographic game objects in real time.
In the future, human AI interaction will be most likely able to provide a plethora of support for people with disabilities. We aim to create a partnership between humans and machines and try to change the modes in a way that they are well adapted to the human's natural behavior. This way, we can integrate AI into everyday life and provide everyone with great help and support in all aspects of their existence. Still, we must keep in mind that there are still many problems faced in the AI research today. Machine learning often works like a black box, meaning that errors are typically hard to trace. This lack of human insight and understanding also leads to the threat of creating biased algorithm outputs through using biased data. Studies have shown that many people still experience an intense discomfort when interacting with AI that is based on a lack of trust. In order to ensure an ethical handling of AI, we must adhere to the values of transparency, accountability, honesty, and fairness. But even with these guidelines in place, we still have to provide structures that ensure these values are realized, evaluated, and ultimately enforced, to ensure a future where we all work ethically together to advance AI research and by that improve all our lives.